Hello and welcome everyone. In the last lecture, we saw how to write a function, how we can declare a function, how we can call a function. We saw all those things. So if you enjoyed that previous lecture, then please like my video, comment down below what you didn't understand, and please subscribe to my channel so that when I bring out more lectures, you get it first at the very soon, okay? So in this lecture, we will see how we can pass arguments in our functions. This is good. How we declared a function and how we called it, this is fine, but it is not that much flexible. Now, in order to make it flexible, we will pass some arguments in it. So how we do that? Let's see. So I've created a new file called functionsargument.php, and which is inside our demo directory. And in the body section, let's drop some PHP in here. Now you already know how to declare a function, so let's do that. So I will declare a function and I will name it greet. Okay, and here I will write an echo statement with a simple hello. Okay, now if I save this, nothing will be getting displayed in the browser because we have only declared the function, we haven't called it yet. So in order to use this function, we need to call this function, and this is how we call a function by its name, just like this. Now if I save this, go to your browser, hit refresh, see, we are getting hello, correct? Now if I make one spelling mistake, any spelling mistake, then this will not work. Call to undefined function gray. Okay, undefined call to undefined function means that we don't have this function declaration, but still we are calling this. So PHP is not able to find it. So we need to call the function by its own name. So this is how I am calling the function. Now, this is simple. This is only function declaration and function calling. There is no passing arguments in it. So let's pass some argument in it. So we will pass arguments from this greet. Okay, when we are calling the function, we need to pass our arguments from here. So how we will pass arguments inside this first bracket? We can write anything. We can write integers, we can write a string, anything. But if we are writing the numbers, then we write it directly. But if we are writing a string, then we need to put double quotation marks. So let's put double quotation marks and let's write any name in here. Okay. So now I am passing this argument. Okay, I am passing this argument in this function. So now if I save this and go to the browser and hit refresh, see, we are only getting hello. Okay, so we need to use this, right? And how we will use this? We need to catch this argument in here. Okay, so how we will catch this? We will store this value in a variable we will create in here. So let's call this variable name. Okay, so what will happen? We are passing this Anirban and it will get stored in this name variable, and we can use this name variable inside our function anywhere. So let's concatenate this dollar name with our echo statement like this. Save this, go to your browser and hit refresh. See, we are getting hello Anirban. Beautiful, right? And we can do anything. We can change the name also. We don't have to write the function repeatedly. We just need to change the arguments and we are getting the result. Okay. Now let me show you how we can pass more arguments. Here we are just passing one argument. We can also pass as many arguments as we want. So let's do that. So let's comment this out first, and here let's create another function. Let's call this calc. Okay, that means calculation. Okay, and now let's call this function calc and like this. So I want to do a addition, okay, inside this calc function. So addition of two numbers, that means I have to pass two numbers. So let's just pass two numbers, 56, and we will put a comma in here. Okay, for the next argument we need to put a comma, and 78 suppose. okay? So we are passing these two values and we need to catch them, right? That means we need to create two variables in here so that they can have these values 56 and 78. So let's create the two variables num1 comma num2. Okay, so now we have this, we are passing these two values and we are getting these two values in here. These two values will get reflected here. Now we can use these two variables num1 and num2 inside our function. So let's create another variable $sum, which is equal to $num1 plus $num2 semicolon, and let's just echo out sum. Save this, go to your browser, hit refresh. See, I'm getting 134. That means it's working perfectly. So this is how I am passing arguments in the function, and we can pass several arguments also. Like, see, we are passing here, we passed a string, and here we are passing integers. We can pass integers as string at the same time. Suppose this will not make any sense to this logic, but let's just show it to you. So if here I put a string and I write here addition, save this. Now let's create a variable here so that it can catch that value of the third parameter, and let's call this add. Okay, now we want to access the value in here also. So what we can do, we can concatenate $add dot and like this. I am just concatenating the strings. Okay, so this $add will have the value addition because that is what we are getting here, and then I am just doing string concatenation with a colon, and then we are concatenating the sum. So if I save this, go to the browser and hit refresh, see, we are getting addition 134. That means we can pass a number of arguments in our function, but we should remember that the number of arguments we are passing from here, same number of arguments we need to create here to catch those values. And we can pass strings also, we can pass integers also, and we can pass them together also. So this is how we write a function, we declare a function, we call a function, and then eventually we also pass arguments in our function. So I hope you are liking this lectures, and if you do, then please do like my videos, share it, and comment down below. If you're having any problem, I will definitely reply it back to you. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please do subscribe so that whenever I bring more lectures, then you get it first. And I will meet you in the next lecture where I will show you that how we can use the return type from our functions to access the values. In here we are just echoing out the final value, correct? But in the next lecture I will show you how we can use the return statement in here and how it will help us. So without wasting any time, let's jump on to the next lecture. Till then, thank you, have a great day.